Speaking of films, I helped you create a short film recently.
Yeah.
Would you like to say anything about it, sir?
Well, I mean, I learned a lot from making it because, I mean, we didn't have any lighting. We didn't have any people working on it other than me and Shelly. Whilst making it, you did the editing.
But while
we were filming and the creating of the story and all of her acting and everything, like, I learned a lot. I wish I would have used my camera, even though it wasn't on a par with hers, because we could have used it for close-up shots and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So I wish we would have had a few more cameras.
We ended up, running around and getting some stock footage and stuff with our camera.
But she did a phenomenal job. Yeah. I think she nailed the body language, the mannerisms, the essence of the friend I was trying to emulate.
Yeah.
In that. And I mean, I feel like I did the least amount of work out of anybody. I just kind of came up with the story and barked orders at her in between filming the same thing three times in a row. I wish I would have barked orders at her during that. So I just kind of wrote a story and was bossy. So I feel like I did like the easiest part of it all.
It may be the easiest part, but it's also the biggest part of it all too, I would think. I don't even really think it is the easiest part, because coming up with the idea and
writing it and all the
bringing
story.
It to life and everything and actually doing it is a huge hurdle to get over, let alone.
Well, I can't thank her enough for helping me with it and coming down and letting me use her camera and being willing to be in front of the camera for all of it. And
yeah, she pulled it off. She acted well.
She was great. You know, like, I hope to collaborate with her more.
Yeah.
In the future, because she did such a great job. But I'm happy with how it turned out. I learned a lot from it. I think I'll do better the next time.
Yeah.
You know, like, if there is a next time.
No, this was your first go around. It was a learning experience.
I don't know.
You kind of nailed it.
I feel like it was more, I don't know if it's, I don't, I'm so bad with terminology, but maybe like guerrilla style is how you would classify it.
Oh, yeah. It was total indie film style.
Well, I mean,
sure.
Even indie film style now, these,
like, even the
these
camera
cats,
shots and.
Well, they rent, like the Reds and stuff. They go places and they rent and they have like crews and they have the boom mics and everything. So like,
yep.
This was even
sound guys,
a step down from like what indie films are nowadays. Like, if you look at short films that people put out there now, they have good production value because you can rent those.
Oh yeah.
Those cameras.
For sure.
And so but that's the best terminology I can think to describe it is guerrilla style, I guess. But
okay. No, I mean, I guess that's a good term.
But that's something I've always wanted to do my whole life, but I don't know the terminology. I don't know the technical terms. A lot of people in the subreddits and the forums and stuff, and when I read about online, they know tons of depth about all the current cameras out, the lenses, like, that's, but
that shit changes every year, too. Or upgrades.
I'm sure all the great directors know a lot about that, but I just, if I want to be a director, I want to be the guy that writes the stories and barks orders behind the camera and inspires people and inspires their emotions and gets what I want out of them. I don't need to know how the cameras run. That's the cinematographer can do that.
Yeah.
Like, he can take care of all that.
You just have the vision and you're trying to make it.
I don't want to set up the lighting.
Create
the cinematographer and the set people can do all that. Like,
yeah.
You know, but obviously I'm in nowhere position to have that kind of a crew.
Technically, it was a two-man production.
Yeah, so I'm happy with that.
So, yeah, I mean, that's what I'm saying. With what you had to work with, you did
credit goes to her with how each shot was set up, you know, because she has a great eye for it. She's a photographer, but I think she'd be a great cinematographer, you know, to be able to set up shots. And if we had more cameras, it would have looked a lot better, too, the cuts and all that. And I genuinely just wrote a story and barked orders, you know, like.
Well, you wanna give some context to the film, I guess? Like, maybe explain the synopsis, sort of.
Well,
I don't know, because people don't know really what to expect.
Well, for lack of a better word, it's a silent film, right? You know, I guess there's background noise.
Yeah, I mean, it's not
there's
silent,
no, there's
but there's
no
dialogue whatsoever.
There's no dialogue.
Yeah, it's all acting.
It's self-medicated. It's essentially, I mean, I guess it'd be, you know, I guess I could say what it is. But I think anybody that watched it would get it. It's about a person that's self-medicating their depression and anxiety with alcohol.
Yeah.
and it's not, you know, it's not the greatest outcome, and it was very tame. Like, we didn't get too graphic or
it's all like
volatile with it, like there could have been, but this was, you know, I wanted her to be most comfortable in filming this stuff, so I didn't want to get too, you know, gutter with it, and you know, and you know,
the message was definitely there. You could see it if you watch it.
Because I feel like I toned it down a whole lot, but I still feel like it definitely hit what I wanted it to hit.
Yeah, yeah. No, I've shown it to two people now, and both of them really enjoyed it, and for the most part, got it. Saw where it was going, saw what happened with it, and got the message.
You know, I've showed it to maybe five or so, and everybody that I've showed it to liked it, but I don't know if they're just being nice.
No,
you know,
I never know that. But
and you know, don't, you know, we haven't acknowledged that. I mean, you did lightweight, but you did all the editing on it. So,
yeah, like I was,
you did,
I was
all
post-production. You guys
yeah,
were
that was all
you. Production. So
that was,
I mean, it
would have
been cool to be there from and look at it from an editing standpoint, you know what I mean? So like it probably could have went a lot smoother, and you know what I mean, I wouldn't have had so many cuts, or there was two scenes in which we were really trying to figure out where can we put these, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
And I think I came up with some pretty decent ideas.
But, yeah, no, I'm really happy with how you
with what we had to work
together
with,
and
I feel
and
like
yeah,
we did a pretty good
and
job
with what I had for you to use. But so I give most of the credit to Shelley and to you. Like, I just kind of...
But again, like I said...
I was, I guess, fortunate enough to have two people willing to help me put something together.
I love that shit.
That was therapeutic for me, you know? That's what it was mainly about, is kind of getting...
It was an expression.
It was an expression, and it was a kind of closure to me on, you know, life experiences. But I would like to parlay that into another short film, and I'd like to... If it ever happens for me, that be a full feature film for me eventually one
your
day.
Your next one you're thinking of right now is what you're saying?
No, that Self Medicated. I'd like to do another indie version of it one day down the road.
And expand
with a little bit
it.
More help, you know, a little bit more graphic, and then eventually make that a feature film.
No, that's a good idea.
If that ever happens.